today we're here at Alton Towers for the opening of Nemesis Sub-Terra.
Oh, yes. Oh,
I've been looking forward to this one for ages. I've been posting loads of updates for ages as well, and I can't believe it's finally opening. After all these years, it's coming back. Really looking forward to experiencing it. We're just walking in now and we're here really early. It's not even 9 o'clock yet. It's 20 to 9, so yeah, on our way down to the park entrance.
Odd choice of music.
It has come to our attention that false information has been shared regarding our investigation into Nemesis. We assure you that our extensive and ongoing tests prove that she poses no danger to the public. And as a gesture of our unshakable confidence, we invite you to view our latest discovery and to learn more about how we are creating a secure future for generations to come at the newly recommissioned Phalanx Research Facility.
We
apologize for that brief interruption. I can assure you that everything is as it should be and is completely under control. And without further ado, it gives me great pride to announce the Phalanx Research Facility. Open. As usual, and I repeat once again, everything is completely under control. Thank you.
I shouldn't be blocking this door, that's
right.
£9.54, heading into the actual queue now. So excited. Excited. TV screens back in place. Moon platform. Stop over here now. This is crazy. Crazy.
We're going in.
I'm really scared. What on earth was that? That was actually so good.
Oh,
what do you think?
Lost for words. I was genuinely scared.
Shaking.
I was genuinely scared. There's one like effect while you're in the seat and it like pokes your back and it off.
mad. The drop isn't actually that forceful. However, the leg ticklers, the water sprays, the poking, oh, they make it. It's so good. It's so atmospheric in there, isn't it? Got to have another ride on it later because that was really good.
I think it is easily one of the best dark rides in the country.
Gotta be. Nemesis Sub-Terra. So we're just heading down towards the Curse at Alton Manor, just because it's on a short queue, we might have a go at that. But yeah, Sub-Terra, really good. We're going to get another ride on it later, hopefully. The operations are really slow, that's the only issue with that. It's because you go into like the first bit and you're waiting to get in the lift. It's a bit like Tower of Terror. Have you ever been on the Tower of Terror, any of the Disney parks? You get like a spot and you stand on your spot and you have to wait for the lift, and then you go into the lift. And the pre-show takes like 3 to 4 minutes, something like that. So it does take a while. However, at the minute, I'm going to give it an 8 out of 10.
Ooh,
we'll see you later. On to our second dark ride of the day. It was only a couple months ago. This area was completely crowded for the opening of Curse at Alton Manor, which was a really good day. Very similar atmosphere to today. Yeah, I love it. When you walk around, see all the theme park vloggers, loads of camera crews, everything like that. But yeah, this is still a great ride. It's a shame how it doesn't get much of a queue really, like, anymore. Which is a shame, because it does deserve it. Much better than Jaws. But yeah, we love this. We've done it like at least 15 times now over it, you know, since it's opened. But yeah, gonna head on to Curse Alton Manor. What's also good to see is the pipe is up again and smoke is coming out. The smoke machines are working again. It's very good to see. What's up?
Mine train
has just stopped. Yeah, I love this. The only shame with this is when it's quiet, they lock this bit out on the extension, so you can't actually go read all the little Easter eggs in the queue. But yeah, gonna go see the devil baby down there. The doomed party. Happy birthday, Emily. Liars. Oh yeah, and it is only like 10:30, I believe. Oh, it's 10:45 now. So we got on about, it was like 10:20-ish. Not too bad. Who's gonna knock the knocker?
I'll knock the knocker.
Thank you.
Oh, well, I won't knock the knocker.
No, the knocker. R.I.P. I can't believe that. Bring it back now.
Sub-Terra is officially better than Curse.
Ready?
They've removed the knocker.
I can't believe the knocker's gone. It's got to be broken. Every time I come in, I knock it. Can't believe that. I knocked the wood instead. There we go. On to Curse. Love this ride. We had a good ride on the Curse at Alton Manor, and they have added some effects in there. It sounded like air cannons to me. I believe, hopefully, they're doing something with the dark section where nothing happens for a bit. Hopefully, they're putting some props in there, and the air cannons are to do with that. But yeah, hopefully we'll see later this year what happens with that. Anyways, we're gonna have a ride on the Congo River Rapids. However, it is really delayed, so we're heading down for a similar ride. We're going on Battle Galleons. Not done this one because this year, just because it's had a bit of downtime recently. But yeah, we're going to go on Battle Galleons.
We're not doing it.
There we are, Battle Galleons. Not done this one in ages. But yeah, looking forward to having a go on here. However, there's lots of people on the guns, so I feel like we're going to get a bit wet. well, we're going to go on Congo, so why not? Let's have a little go on this one. Forward to this. I forgot, when you walk through the queue line, you get wet because people spray you, and there is opportunities to spray other people as well. But yeah, looking forward to this one. Had a great ride on Battle Galleons. Lovely weather for it. Harry's absolutely soaked because we had one of the boats that were in front of us. They were shooting like mad. And there was lots of sections where we were facing each other, and we just went absolutely crazy. But yeah, a little bit wet. Definitely going to go on it again later. It's so nice to have a bit of a, you know, a refresh because it's so hot today. Have a little cool down. Here we are, walking down Food Street. We've gone to have a look at the Mardi Gras things that are going on here. Taking it to the streets. The towers look absolutely stunning today. In the sunshine. Love it. Such a busy day, but it's just amazing vibes. Here we go, let's head down Food Street. So from this end, got a deli. Sandwich, pastrami, cheesesteak, interesting. And then you've got cakes, donuts, ice cream. Cool. Little stage there. And then what's this? Is this fish and chips? Sandwiches, chips, fish and chips. There we go. And there's like stages here, loads of seating areas. Coffee and crepe van. Ooh, crepe, Harry. Should we see what crepes I've got?
I want to stand up and get the crepes out.
It's great. That was the Smiler stage. I was in the X Sector for Smiler Takeover. We've got a Mardi bar. This is great with all the benches. We did stop at Food Street, we sat on one of the benches and we had some crepes that were actually really good, weren't they?
Yes.
Adding Nutella banana, Harry just had plain sugar, but they were both really good. Heading towards Towers Trading, we're going to have a look at the new Mardi Gras pins and possibly get some mystery ones as well. This is crazy, coming back on Towers Street, got loads more dancers, loads more benches, this is amazing. Great atmosphere, especially when it's really busy like today. There we go, look at this, Mardi Gras. This is great, there's people on stilts walking around as well. Oh, cool. Going to have a ride, all wicker man. Advertised 50 minutes, we've waited about 50 minutes now, haven't we? Nearly an hour, and we're about to get to the baggage hall. Yeah, so I'm riding wicker man. Ride on Wicker Man there. Row 7, it was really fast. Did you like it, Harry?
Yes, I did.
It was good because it's warm and the track's warmed up. It was really fast. We had a really good ride. We did wait just under an hour there, so not too bad. Pretty much it's the same as advertised. So we've had a look at the Queue for Congo and it's huge. People at the back are probably going to be 45 minutes, an hour.
Huge queue
like
for the River Rapid.
So we're heading to Kersal Manor again instead. I did want to do Battle Galleons, but we're quite far away from it now. Can't be bothered walking back, so we'll do it again later. We're going to do Curse, and I think we're just going to stick it in Queue for Sub-Terra again. Here we are then, back in the queue for the Curse at Alton Manor. Love this one, it is kind of our go-to ride when we're going to watch it, because we do like it, and usually it's walk-on, so yeah, pretty much walk-on.
And the knocker's broken.
Oh. On the 31st of December, 1891, Mr. and Mrs. Alton held a party to celebrate the turning of the new year. However, on the final chime of midnight, the manor appeared to be struck by a storm of supernatural proportions. All known occupants of the house perished. Aside from the owner's only child,
Emily.
More track. Looks like an inversion. How cool. And there you go, there's the station. So, we're gonna head on to Glad's Canal. We had a good ride on Curse, however, it did break down for a total of like 10 seconds, and we did miss some of the effects at the start. They just weren't working properly. but that's because it did break down and then it went back up running again. But still, it's a decent ride. Now we're headed on the Galactica because we can see it's on size 15 and the queue is incredibly short, so yeah, let's go have a ride. This isn't too bad at all, just walk past the vending machines and we're heading over here where we can pick station 1 or 2. Yeah, so yeah, pretty much walk on from here, but it may end up taking 5-10 minutes in the station. Picking station 1, see how long we wait in here, might end up taking 10 minutes or so, but still pretty decent. Nemesis Sub-Terra is taking the spotlight today in Forbidden Valley.
Absolutely. Come on.
Less than 10 minutes, which is really good, wasn't it? We timed it so well because there was like no queue at all when we got on. There's only a 10 minute one from like the station onwards. And then when we left, the queue was huge, like past the vending machines. So yeah, good timing there and good ride. We're heading onto the observation platform now. Sub-Terra is having downtime. It has broke down and they have cleared the queue. So not sure how long that's gonna take, but we'll come back and we will get another ride on it today. But yeah, you're just gonna look observation platform whilst we're here. The construction. We have noticed behind this bit of monorail there is actually a piece of track, like just over there. Oh, monorail's going past. There we go. So on our ride on Galactica, we noticed from the lift hill that the last inversion has actually gone into place. So I'm not sure if that bit of track I was talking about over there might be the like last kind of turn out of that inversion, and then they joined together to make it. But yeah, we saw the track had been fitted, so yeah. Loving the updates, especially from Galactica. You get to see Lowe's, don't you? Sub-Terra's reopened. Let's go. We only hung out for about 10-15 minutes outside waiting for it.
I knew it was worth it.
It was worth waiting, wasn't it? Because we didn't want to do it again today, so yeah. Very happy. So we've had not one but two rides on Nemesis Sub-Terra. How are those? Did you enjoy those?
Oh, amazing again.
Love it. So the second go that we had just then, so our third of the day, it was a really forceful drop. We're on number 2, which dropped first, which is great because we got to drop down and you get to see everyone else drop down as well. It's quite forceful, actually got a bit of air time, which is good, and the effects are just great in there. I love it. It is, it's an amazing dark ride, to be fair. I'm glad they've invested in it because it's so worth it. I know, don't know if people have the same opinion, but we definitely think it's a good investment, don't we?
Yeah.
Best dark ride at Alton Towers, like Harry said. I agree, I love it, and we're definitely gonna keep going on it every time we come here. So we're just gonna walk down now, kind of head to the front of the park because we want to catch the parade at 6 o'clock, but that's not for a while yet, so we might get in a few more rides, maybe Oblivion, maybe Battle Galleons, and you know, wait over that side near Food Street is called for the parade. Smiler. Now we're headed on to Oblivion and it looks walk on. It's a good thing about the end of the day, it's only 5:15. Some people go home, but it's better to stick around to the very end and you get walk on rides at the end of the day. Anyway, 25 for the Smiler and I'll walk on Oblivion. A ride on Oblivion, good as always, however the brake run is really harsh, but yeah, it was basically walk on, wasn't it? Good ride.
Yes, mate.
Gonna try to get a last couple rides in, maybe just a one. We're gonna head to 13, get on that, and then we're gonna watch the Mardi Gras parade. Here we are, heading into the dark forest. I think Rita's down, so 13 it is. We were gonna do 13 anyway, so hopefully the queue's quite short. Down by 13, you can see it's closed, and on the app it's also saying closed, which is very
disappointing. I think it's time for
Battle Galleons. There we go then. Instead of these two, I don't think they're going to sort them. It's only half an hour now to park closed, so they're not really going to reopen them. Unfortunately, didn't get the last ride of the day on 13. However, we're going to head over to Battle Galleons for another go on that. We had a good last ride of the day on Battle Galleons. Got soaked on there, my back soaking, Harry's back soaking as well, but it was so worth it just having a nice cool down. We're just going to catch the Mardi Gras parade now, so I'll put some shots of that.